So how do you ventilate in order to, if you can, if you want to use the good stuff, how do you keep it from getting into your lungs? Well, dilution ventilation is what we have in this room. So you see the ducts up there, and the little strip of paper that's stuck to the exhaust duct indicates that it's working. This is designed to bring fresh air in and pull stale air out. So all the carbon dioxide we're breathing out goes out, and fresh clean air comes in. And that's what happens when you open your windows in your house and you kind of air it out. That's dilution ventilation. That's great for just general improvement of air quality, but it does not deal with getting specific toxins away from you. In order to do that, you want to use either local exhaust ventilation or you want to get outside where the dilution ventilation is really good. So local exhaust is basically taking a fan and a tube of some kind. And if this is where I'm working with the toxic stuff, I want to have that fan close enough that any toxic dust or vapors I'm generating are shooting out through that thing and going right outside. Trust me, the universe can handle the tiny amounts of stuff you throw outside your house or studio way better than your lungs can handle it if you breathe it in. The way to test to see whether that's pulling well enough is you can just generate a little bit of smoke. Take a piece of rolled up newspaper, light it, blow it out, and start at where the fan's pulling it and see how far back you go before the smoke starts going up. Once it starts going up, the point between where the smoke goes up and where you touch the duct, that's your safe working location. If you go outside, just going outside isn't enough. You actually need to pay attention to which way the wind's blowing. Because if you're working with the nasty stuff here and you're here and the wind's blowing this way, you're really not making it a whole lot safer. You can buy indoor air cleaners. A person this morning who is an artist working here with oil paints has one in her studio. And basically what this has is it's got a kind of a little elephant trunk type siphon duct. It goes into a box which has filters in it. It's got a particulate filter to capture any dust and pollen and other things. Hers has a dehumidifier because she's down in the basement and it's kind of wet and clammy and it takes that out. It also has an organic vapor cartridge, which is activated carbon. And what that does is that pulls any of those solvent vapors in it and sticks those to the carbon. And then the air comes back into her studio. And she changes it out. She changes the filters about once a year. And every couple of years, she has a technician come in and service the machine and clean the whole machine out to make sure it's in good shape. So that's an option. They're several hundred dollars. But if you don't have much in the way of ventilation that you can set up, that's a good option. The thing you don't want to do is go online and look up air purifier and buy one of these ozone generators. Ozone is three oxygen molecules stuck together. Normal oxygen is O2, two oxygen molecules nicely bonded together, very stable, very healthy. The third oxygen molecule is what we call a free radical. And we all know nowadays that free radicals are really bad for you. This is the free radical generator. Because it's generating O3, and that third oxygen is going to let go, and it's going to look to bond to something else. And it's going to bond to your lungs, and it's going to bond to your carpet and the wood, and it's going to start breaking all of those things down into new compounds. Because oxygen is going to combine into a new compound by stripping molecules out of that. There's a woman in Seattle who called me up, and she put one of these things down in her basement to get rid of the bad smells in her basement before she sold her house and had it running for an entire weekend. And she came down and it melted her carpet. She walked down in there, and by the time she had turned it off, she almost passed out because her lungs were burning, her eyes were burning, and the stench was horrible. And a month later, it still was in bad shape. She stripped out the carpet. She's calling me up and asking me what I would do. And I said, well, I'd remove the carpet and I'd open the windows. And after that, I don't know. I don't know anybody who's done an experiment like this. And I don't know if she ever got it fixed. These things are really, really dangerous. Do not buy ozone generators. Even though it smells like the ocean, it's not the ocean. I mean, you know what the ocean smells like. That's fresh air. Well, that little bit of ozone it's generating is diluted by a massive amount of really clean air, except you're probably getting stuff from Europe, I suppose. But in the Sahara Desert, dust clouds, when you get great sunsets out here, sometimes it's because there's been a massive sandstorm in Northern Europe or Northern Africa.